Okay, so let's talk about how to use a pen tool to create your character illustration where you are mimicking a character that's already been drawn. This is going to help you practice the pen tool without having to worry about what you're actually creating. So the first thing you need to do is create a print size document. Your artboard can be whatever size it needs to be, but it does need to be big enough so it can be printable, so it needs to be 300 resolution, CMYK, etc. Find a large, high definition image of your picture. Don't grab something that's pixelated. And do file place and place it on your stage and transform it, don't skew it, so that it sits on your stage perfectly or on your document perfectly. So, what we need to do now is we need to make this a little bit less, or we need to make it more transparent and we need to lock it so we can use our pen tool on top of it. So, to do that, we're going to click on the image. Go to our transparency panel, and if you can't see this, go to Window and choose Transparency. And we're going to bring our transparency down to wherever you like it so that you can see the pen tool on top of it. Now, with that layer selected, I'm going to go ahead and name this as Original Image. And I'm going to click this empty box next to the eyeball so that I can lock this layer so I can't accidentally click and drag Mickey around. Now I need to create a new layer, and these you might create more layers for different things. So, for instance, if you do his foot and then you do the top of his foot, having his foot or his feet maybe on one layer and then his legs on another layer, it might help you to get your objects all in stacking order. So, for right now, we're going to grab the pen tool, make sure we have no fill. And I have a 1-point black stroke. So I'm going to zoom in to a particular area. And again, I would make sure that you're working in chunks so that you can fill it later with the fill tool. So even though you can't see the back of his foot, I'm going to pretend that it's a whole shape. So I'll just start right here. And then I'll click and drag. And remember with this pen tool, if you mess up, you can always come back later and adjust it using the direct selection tool, which is the white arrow. So click and drag since this is a round object. And don't forget that you can hold the Alt or the Option key so that you can adjust your anchor point. You can turn it into a corner anchor point. Oops, see how I got a problem happening right there? And then click on your very start anchor point to connect. Now, I don't care that that's a straight line, and actually, I don't really care that this is messed up, but again, I can click on my direct selection tool, click on that anchor point, and actually, what I can do is I can get rid of this anchor point by dragging it back in to its original anchor. That still leaves this handle, but now you've got this one where you can sort of create that curve. So we'll find this handle. Try to create a curve that I think would be back there. And there we go. So eventually what you're going to do is you are going to put the color yellow, sorry, inside of this shape. So when that time comes, you can unlock your original image and you can change its transparency back to 100%. And then what you can do is what I would actually do is I would use the color picker to choose all of these colors. And I would actually come into my swatches panel, wherever it is. And again, if you can't see it, open it this way. And I would create new and I would type shoes. And then I would color pick the red on his pants and type pants and do his entire character. So he's pretty simple. So I can call this skin and tongue, and there you go. So once you're done with each shape, now you have all four of those colors for your image. So I can click a new color group and I can do Mickey and put all four of these swatches in there. And I could come into each of these shapes. So this one I just created with the pen tool, and I can fill them with the colors I just chose. So see, this is why we create separate objects so that we can fill it completely. But the problem is that obviously we need to create this shape now. So you would create this yellow shape, and then this might just be one line that you do some variable width to, so that you can create that definition right there, and then you add the black leg on top of it, etc. So that's the basics of creating your mimicked character in Illustrator using the pen tool, and it is good practice for you. So remember, try to pick something that's a little bit challenging for you, not too easy, but also not too hard, because as you can see, I'm going to have to create each one of these shapes, and then maybe later I'm going to have to go through and look at how wide each of these strokes are, because for instance, in his hand right here, it gets thick and thin at different parts.